Had done all the shunting in the yard. "Always adaptable," he said to the engines. "Going anywhere, not needing rails, anything I can do apart from ploughing a field. Still remember when I told you if you would be like me?"
"Yes," said Percy, "but we can't plough in a field. Except I did once."
"I did tell you steam engines did plough once upon a time, but that wasn't in a field," said Terence. The Percy to Mavis took longer than expected, and Toby became used to trundling off to the quarry each morning. Because of Toby's small water tank, his crew had arranged with the quarry master that they should bring loader trucks down to Sheffield docks at lunchtime instead of later in the day. It saved time too, for Toby would otherwise have needed a drink on the way back. He took a drink from it before the journey started. Time passed, and the weather became colder, with hard frosts during the night. They didn't worry Toby. His fire kept him nice and warm. He puffed happily to and fro, arranging the trucks, taking them down to the dock and bringing back empty ones. One night, it was particularly cold. The ground froze solid, and even Toby felt chilly. He shivered as he left the shed and set out to Mount Farrell Quarry light engine. When the ground freezes, it swells. At the road crossing where Mavis had an accident, the frost had swollen the ruts beside the rails so much that Toby's wheels were lifted clean off the track. There was a crunching noise, a rumbling, and Toby began to shudder. He was horrified. "Whoa!" he exclaimed. "What's happening?" "The line here goes on to a junction." But Toby, with no rails to guide his wheels, simply went straight on. Shakily, Toby came to a stop with all six wheels firmly on the roadway. "Oh dear," he said, looking at the grass verge in front of him. "Now what? Is fireman jumped down?" "No problem," he said. "With care, we we can have you back on the rails in no time. I don't see how, said Toby sadly. Directed by the fireman, the driver carefully backed Toby along the ruts his wheels had just made. At last, with a thud and a jolt, Toby felt the rails safely beneath his wheels. Once more, he heaved a sigh of relief as firemen spreaded hot cinders to melt the frozen bit. Then Toby set off again. Mavis was mended and was back. When she came home, the fat controller came up. What's this I hear, Toby? He asked, trying to go on roads again. Oh, sir, it's only the bump I hit. He told him about Terence. The fat controller laughed. If I were you, he said, I should leave the roads to road machines, not my engines. That way, lines for your wheels are comfortable. Toby, the chairman, had to agree.